Good morning, students. Today in this video we have chapter 6, class 4, general science, and the topic for today is adaptation in animals. Here we have two objectives. The first is learn the need and the reasons for adaptation in animals, and the second is to know about various adaptation in animals. So these are the two objectives that we will be learning in this chapter. So let us move on with the first objective, that is to know the need and the reasons for adaptation in animals. So why there is a need and the reasons for adaptation in animals? So let us find out what is the reason. So here in this earth there has been a different kinds of places. There are places where it is very cold, like the polar region. There are places where it is very, very hot, like deserts. So we can find variety of living organisms in these places. Okay, so the natural environment or places where these animals or plants live is called its habitat. So but sometimes what happens is the environment becomes so harsh that these animals need to adapt themselves to survive in certain places. So what happens in such cases, in order to survive, the organisms or the living the animals, they need to adapt or change itself according to its surroundings, right? So this adjustment to the environment to survive is called adaptation, right? So with this, I hope you understand why there is a need and the reasons for adaptation in animals. Now let us move on with the second objective, that is know about various adaptation in animals. Okay, so we know that different kinds of animals have different habitats, so they need food and shelter to live, for which they depend on the environment they live. Okay, so depending upon its habitat, these animals are categorically divided into different types. Okay, so let us know and learn them one by one. The first is adaptation to habitat. So depending upon the habitats, the animals, there are certain animals and they are divided into different categories. Alright, the first is the terrestrial animals. Second is the aquatic animals. The third is the amphibians. And the fourth one is aerial animals, and the fifth is arboreal. So these are the five types or the kinds of animals that are divided according to their habitat, right? So let us learn them one by one. First is the terrestrial animals. Okay, now what is terrestrial animals? These are the animals that basically live on the land. Okay, so these kind of animals, they have certain features like they have lungs to breathe in air. Many of them have sharp teeth to chew or catch their food, And most of the land animals have well-developed legs to move and run from one place to the other or to protect themselves from the predators. And some of the animals also have a well-developed sense organs to help them to look for food and to feel changes in their surroundings. So these are some of the basic features which these kind of animals have. Okay, and the second is aquatic animals. So what are these aquatic animals? These animals are the animals that live in water. They can live only in water. Okay, we can take examples like fish. Okay, fish, dolphin, octopus. So these are some of the animals of the examples of the aquatic animals. So these animals also have certain features for which they are able to live in the water. Okay, so like they have the gills. The fishes have the gills to breathe. They breathe through the gills. And they have fishes like dolphins. The dolphins, they breathe with their lungs. Okay, so these are aquatic animals. Now amphibians. What are these amphibians? The amphibians are the animals that live both on land and in water. Okay, so these amphibians are a type of animal that can live both in land, on the land and in water. So we can take the example as frog, okay, toad and newt. So these are the three animals that basically they live, they can survive both in the land, on land and in water. So they also have some features that help them to live or make them survive and adapt themselves both on land and in water. Okay, like they have a limb that help them to swim. They swim with the help of the limbs, and they have webbed feet to help them swim. Okay, and they breathe with their moist skin. On the land, they breathe with their lungs, but when they are in the water, they breathe with their moist skin. So there are some features that the amphibians have. Now the fourth is the aerial animals. So these are the animals that can fly. We can take some of the examples like birds. Okay, so the birds, they fly in the air. So they don't live on the land or in the water, but they fly in the air. Most of the time they spend in the air. Okay, so they also have certain features that helps them to fly. That is, they have a very light body. Their body weight is very light, so that they can fly easily, right? And they also have feathers all over their bodies that help them warm during the flight. Okay, and they also have a hollow bones, and their forelimbs are modified as wings. So these are some of the basic features of aerial animals. Now the last one, that is the arboreal animals. So what are these animals? These are the animals that basically live on the trees. They like living on the trees, like monkey. Okay, we can take the example like monkey, squirrel. So these are the few animals that live on the trees. So these animals also have certain features that allow them to live on the trees. So the first is they have sharp claws with a strong grip to help them climb up the trees. Okay, so these features of having a sharp claws with a strong grip help them to climb up the trees. Okay, and the second features we can take is their body is very strong with a stout chest, bones and limbs. Okay, their bodies are very, very strong. So because of that, they can jump from one tree to the other. Okay, So these are some of the features that these animals have. So I hope students you have understood these kind of animals. And depending upon the adaptation for food, the animals are further again divided into different kinds. Okay. Let us also see them one by one. First, we have learned adaptation to habitats. The second is adaptation for food. Okay. So animals can also be divided, as I have said, into different categories based on their eating habits. Like the first is herbivores. Okay. The second is carnivores. The third is omnivores. And there are also certain animals like scavengers. Okay, we learn that scavengers, and the last is the parasites. Okay, we will also learn what is parasites and scavengers. Okay, so depending upon their food habits, the animals are also further divided into different types. Okay, or kinds. There is herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers, parasites. Now let us know what is herbivores. Okay, so let us learn one by one. Herbivores are the animals that totally depend on the plants as their food. Okay, and we can take some of the examples like buffalo, cow, zebra, goat. So these are some of the animals that belong to these types of animals. Okay, that is herbivores. And the second is the carnivores, right? Second is the carnivores. These are the animals that depend upon the other animals. They eat the flesh of the other animals or birds. Okay, so these are carnivores. Example, we can take lion, tiger. So these are some of the animals that belong to the carnivores. Okay, and we can also add like leopard, wolf. So they depend on the other animals. They eat the flesh of other animals. So that is why they are regarded as the carnivorous animals. Okay, and the third is omnivores. Omnivores are the animals that eat both plants and the flesh of the other animals. Okay, we can take example like bear, crow, woodcutter, raccoon. So these are some of the animals or birds that eat both flesh and plants. Okay, and the fourth one is scavengers. So what are these scavengers? These are the animals that feed on the dead animals or plants. Okay, so we can take the examples like vultures. So when the animals die due to many reasons, the vultures, they used to come and eat those flesh. So that is why they are regarded as scavengers, right? And finally, the last one is the parasite. So these parasites, they don't eat the flesh or the remains of the dead animals, but they are like, they derive the nutrition, they take the nutrition from other animals. Like they suck the blood of other animals. We can take the example as leech, okay, leech. So these animals like leech, tapeworm, these are the animals that are present in the body of the other animals. they also suck blood and they collect the nutrition from the other animals. Okay, so I hope you understand this. So till now we have learned about the adaptation to habitats and adaptation for food. So I hope students, all of you, understood these points. So with this we are able to complete both the objectives that I have mentioned in the beginning of this video. Thank you.